Hey guys, Jimmy here, and welcome back to iRacing for another video. Today we are back in the C-Fixed Trucks, this time at Texas, and we are joined by special guest Matt Malone, aka Showdown 1983. Say hello, Matt.
Hey Jimmy, here I am, ready to truck it in Texas.
So Matt and I had a little bit of a discussion before coming in, and this is your first time spotting, Matt, is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
So you're going to give me any sort of... I mean, I'm not getting much confidence right now.
I got to admit. Just trust me, Jimmy. You'll be fine. The truck is well-suited for you. You want to use that big pedal on the far right, and you'll be fine.
After our shenanigans last time at Martinsville, which involved punting someone to get into second position, we are at Texas, which is, I think, a mile and a half oval, I believe, and very fast round. It also eats tyres, so... I'm not really quite sure how to approach this, Matt. I mean, last time I drove Texas, it was during our series on Twitch, Friday Night Trucks, which I think was at the tail end of, like, 2013. So
it's Friday Night Trucks with Jimmy Broadbent and Matt Malone, only on Grip TV. Yeah, I remember those days.
The thing is, though, I don't remember how to drive it. That's the bad thing.
You're right about the tires here in Texas, because they'll get shredded quick. So at any opportunity you can get new tires, you want to throw four of them on there. So any type of caution. So I would just say, just thinking here, just take it nice and easy. Keep those tires nice and soft. And then if there's a caution, you just roll on in, get four freshies, and then just keep on going. Because I think a lot of people are going to be getting loose out of turn two and turn four here, and you can get some freebies.
Did a bit of practice earlier on, and coming out of two and, or just coming out of two and going to one, it's a very harsh transition from sort of the level to the oval. It's a very sudden change, and it can upset the back of the car, especially coming out of two, because I've definitely hit that wall three or four times so far in practice. So if we're going to crash anywhere, it's going to be there, but hopefully we won't crash and give you guys a nice video to watch.
Yeah, and I know you've been doing a lot of dirt racing, so just forget everything you've been doing in dirt, and it'd be real easy.
So here we are in qualifying, just pulling out of the pits now, and I'm a number six car, so aiming to try and get a decent result this race. Out of my last 11 oval events, 10 of those finishes have been in the top five, so I'm trying to keep that going, but qualifying time, and you might notice that we have one casualty already. The stress ball has fallen. It's not wanting to stay behind the throttle today, so I'm going to just race without it. Try and get used to it. But anyway, qualifying. Can actually really wreck these tyres on the qualifying lap. It's quite nice, because I tend to try and drive a bit more conservatively in the race. But here we go then. First lap underway. Trying to get as much speed as possible into one. Keep it in the middle and then come back down again. Back on the throttle. Let the rear dictate where the car's going. Trying to touch apron at the bottom. There you go. Full throttle. Nice. Aim for the wall on the outside. Oh, that was as close as I can get without touching it. Now into three. Get off the throttle a little bit, try and bring it down. A little bit of understeer at the front there. Using the throttle to bring it back down. Again, aim for that wall up top. And then diagonal to the line. That's one lap. That wasn't a bad lap. I haven't done many qualifying laps around here because I've been sort of practicing the race. 29.8, that isn't too bad. Have another stab at it. Again, nice and low there. Full throttle for most of that. Do that line throughout the race, the rear end becomes a little bit skittish, so we'll be avoiding that throughout the actual race, but for qualifying it's fine. A bit wide there, but come on throttle, there you go, bring it down. Is this going to be an improvement? I don't think so, but we'll go to the line anyway. It's going to be a 29.278. Okay, we do improve only slightly, but currently I'm seeing us in 10th spot, so maybe not too great at qualifying from us.
Not too shabby. Sean Woodside with a 29.4. He's obviously cheating.
Oh, jeez. All right. Okay. We're screwed, boys. Yeah,
starting in 11th right now. A lot of people still haven't put in a time yet, so we'll see. Uh-oh, there you dropped down to 12th.
I'm enjoying this running commentary of me getting slightly worse down the down
you
the
like
field.
Running mid-pack, though. That's where all the action is.
So qualifying over, and as you can see, we sort of sucked. Out of everyone who set a time, we came second to last in 14th spot of a 29.7. The leader, Jordan DeBeck, did a 29.2, so half a second faster. We're going to go to the grid now. Not really sure what to make of this, Matt. I mean, I'd usually start sort of mid-pack, but now we're starting pretty much right at the back, and of course I want to try and avoid any sort of shenanigans, so I'm not quite sure what approach to take now. That's sort of thrown me.
Well, unfortunately, yeah, if there's going to be a wreck, it's probably going to be in front of you, so you got to keep your eyes open here. Yeah,
Got to rely on my top-notch spotter.
Yeah, here I am. I'm far above the track here. I got eyes on everything. I even got eyes on the concession stands. I'm going to be swinging over there soon.
Pick up some cool Coors Light.
That's right.
This video is sponsored by Coors Light.
Well, we're going to need a cold one because the track temp's up to 103 degrees Fahrenheit track temp, so it's hot here in Texas. So that's going to do, it's going to damn it. It's going to shred these tires real quick. So if we can, if you can take care of your tires, I think that's going to be beneficial.
Yeah, I'm wondering if we'd have the pace over the stint. Yeah, you know, I was saying to you while we were just sort of in between qualifying there that I've done a lot of practice, but sort of on a race tire, and so that with worn tires, I haven't done so much practice on the qualifying tire, which is why I think I qualified so low. But hopefully it will come to us during the race. I'm still using the clutch, even though my clutch doesn't really work anymore. Just, you know, muscle memory. Rip clutch.
Well, get into fourth and away you go.
Yeah, pretty much. Well, here we are then, pulling away. So one to green. The only thing you can't see as a spotter is when we're about to go green, and we say like 2 to green, 1 to green after a caution. So I'll try and keep you filled in on that. But we're starting behind, who's this in front? The 15, which is Kirk Smith. Try to drive into the back of him. That'll be a good start to the race. Doggo's in the background here to cheer me on.
Yeah, Kirk Smith, he's the number 15 car, so, you know, he'll be happy with, like, last place, so he'll let you go.
I'll be happy with surviving. I mean, we are right... I mean, how many cars? It's 18 in total, was it? Or
19 cars on the grid here.
Okay, so we're not quite last, but nearest makes no difference at this point. A top five would be pretty cool to continue our trend, but I don't hold high hopes for that. Can we please... Thank you very much. Guys in front sort of forgetting they've got to be close to the start of the race.
Yeah, these guys may want to try to jump the start here. They better bunch up quick. Pace car's going to be leaving here soon.
So we'll start in second gear. We'll have a bit of a disadvantage off the line because we have no clutch, but there's green.
Oh, you got a guy going three wide.
Nope.
Yeah, stay high here if you can. Low line is available for you. That car behind you, though, is a little crazy. These guys get a little chippy.
Ah, come on.
There you go.
I think I just killed him. Oh, shit, I just killed him. He sort of just stopped.
Fine. Rubin's racing.
Rubin's racing. It's not been very long. We've already killed someone, so continuing the Martinsville tradition.
You got a guy outside. Clear, clear.
Oh, man. I feel bad about that. He sort of just stopped in front of me. Nothing I could do about that.
Yeah, I'd just say it's netcode. The yellow car, oh, okay, you're clear, clear.
Lost the draft now, which is frustrating, but we'll try and get back. This yellow car is looking pretty feisty, so I'll probably just let him go for now. We'll see what happens.
Yeah, it'd be smart of him to work with you, but he's going to take this here.
I'm going to go for it. I don't mind too much. Going to try and save those tyres a bit. I've never really been good at Texas. I mean, even back at Friday Night Trucks, I can remember not being very good here. That's about as much as I remember.
Yeah, getting a good exit is tough, and taking care of tires.
Also, no stress ball. I'm going to blame my lack of performance on that right now, because the stress ball is pivotal to my speed.
That's right, that's right. So maybe if you can just stick with this yellow car, maybe we can get caught back up to the pack here. We're hoping for a caution.
Okay, let's try and take the low line as long as I think it's possible to do so. Seem pretty feisty up ahead, so maybe there'll be something, but I don't want to burn these tires.
Yeah, they're going almost three wide up there, so I'll keep an eye up on the front pack and just race your line here.
Oh geez, a bit wide there. Use the throttle to bring it down. There you go. The wall on the right comes up so quickly, it's quite scary actually.
Oh, we got guys into the wall. We got a guy coming up on the track. Slow, slow. Go high. Oh, nice avoidance. More wrecking. Go. Stay high, stay high, stay high.
Oh, Jesus Christ. That was interesting.
So caution flag's got to be out, right?
Yeah, there's caution's out. Three cars there dying. So we get some freebies.
Wreck avoidance. Nice, dude.
Freebies, but we are sort of not very fast right now. So I guess we're going to move up a couple of places here. I don't know. I don't think we should pit just yet. What do you reckon? We'll see what the leaders do, I suppose.
Well, since we're kind of in the back, you might as well just pit. Do full pit stop here.
Mm-hmm. That's not a bad idea, so we'll just catch up to the pace car. So a pretty explosive start here to Texas. Luckily we weren't caught up in that. I mean, it's really hard to try and predict where cars are going to go on the oval because the banking really skews how the cars act, or how the trucks act, I should say. So sometimes you think, oh yeah, I'm clear, I'll go down the bottom. But then, of course, gravity's against you and the guy falls back down from the top of the banking and just completely clatters you. But that's it. So, Mr. Malone, you are in charge of our pits, of our... of our tyre strategy. So we're going to go full tyres, and we're going to have no fuel, please.
Yep, that's right. No fuel, no windshield tear off, because that takes like a half a second. You don't want that. And full four tyres, yep. And I checked out your car, no damage or anything, so you're looking clean. It was just a little tap that you gave that guy.
Nice, okay. So this would be good for that guy to sort of get back into it again. Where's my fella? There he is. I'm just about to see him. It's hard to pick up the guy right here. I'm with Matt Orr when you said you really need to give these guys high vis jackets.
Yeah.
Okay, so full service. Everyone else with the same idea. I don't think anyone said that actually.
Yeah, I think literally everyone pitted.
Yeah, it's a sensible thing to do
at
this point.
Some guys might be only taking two tires, but I think four tires is the play here.
Not sure.
Oh, look at that.
Gained any time there, did we? We must have done. I feel like we've gained some positions there. Pit crew bonus for them, I think.
Heck yeah, they get a raise.
So what we'll do, guys, is we'll cut it here and we'll come back when we go back to green. Right, so we're back, and after the pit stops, we came out in a net position of 8th, so we made up some places there, which is pretty cool. Matt brought up an interesting point, actually, that this is a track that I think that cautions will happen just because of the banking. So maybe it's worth just trying to burn the tyres as opposed to trying to save them. I think that might be a better strategy. So I guess we'll give that a go and just hope for cautions, because I think over this length of race, we can't really afford to be saving tyres.
Burn them up, Jimmy. Here we go. Starting on the outside could be tough here.
Yeah, I've got eyes on the leader. And there goes the leader, and away we go.
Got a guy inside, that yellow guy. You got Mr. High Life to the inside. Getting a little freight train there from the inside.
I got
wrecked
there. You
can grab the inside now if you want. Oh, going for the block. Oh, this guy doesn't like it. You got a car on the inside.
Christ almighty, being on the outside was a bad idea, wasn't it?
Yeah.
We got shuffled then. Oh, Jesus.
Whoa,
Christ.
This guy's right on you.
I think this is a dude that I hit earlier.
Uh-oh, he's back for
I think
revenge,
he's back
folks.
To get me. So I've got to really just burn those tyres now. No point really saving them. Plus I've got to try and get away from this guy behind me because he wants my blood now.
Yeah, he does.
I'm trying not to go over there. Oh, the apron there at the bottom.
He's... high line, stay low here.
Ah, I got a bit of a push.
Oh, now he's going low.
I'll just let him have it. I don't really want to force him up too much. I feel like I still feel bad for the incident earlier. The most British truck racer of all time, ladies and gentlemen.
This is a pretty top-tier split here, so these guys have put their practice in, that's for sure.
Yeah, you were surprised to hear that I practiced before the event, Malone. I'm not quite sure how to take that, to be honest.
Well, I saw your iRating chart, and it's straight up, so maybe you're starting to get into the splits with more of your competition level here. You might have had it easy there for the first couple weeks.
Yeah, now I can't win anymore.
Car on your outside here, or it's a truck, I guess.
A truck, I guess, on your outside.
You can't put anything in the back. I don't know why it's a truck. I want to load up some hay bales.
Can you imagine that was a requisite? You'd have to, like, you have to do a race with like a full set of like farming equipment in the back. So go with
ballast. I got me a chipper. Oh, these guys are got some green car on your high side there. All right, that's an overtake.
These guys are too wide.
Yeah, just try to stay to the inside best you can here. Really no pressure from behind quite yet, so you can kind of use all the track.
Trying not to fight the tires too much at the moment. Still trying to go as low as possible and take as much speed as possible, but doing so while not scrubbing the tires, as I am a little bit there. Now they're hooked, now they're scrubbing. Now they're hooked. Oh, blue car hit the apron then. As did I, actually. Oh, Christ, three wide in front, no, 2x2.
Whoa, here we go. Oh, more contact, stay low here.
Oh, truck's getting a little bit oversteery now.
Yeah, I bet it is. It's tough here in Texas. Stay low, you got a truck on your high side. He's got that Miller High Life paint job.
So almost, that was very, very it's Miller time on the back or something.
Yeah.
I remember following one of those in the Daytona 500 and being like, oh, I want to catch Miller. Like, I didn't know who he was. I just wanted to catch the guy called Miller.
It's not Miller time yet. We got 35 laps. So coming up to lap 18 here.
Up to 8th, not bad.
Yeah. It's getting pretty spread out now, so we may have a long green stretch here. So tires, maybe it wasn't such a good idea to shred them.
God damn it.
Oh, boy.
This is what happens when I give you responsibility, Matt.
Well, you know. I got my tires usually shredded before I even leave the pits.
Yeah, getting a little bit of a... It's not a bad slide. It's sort of a controllable one. I think I'm... But I don't want to be doing that too much because iRacing and how tires heat up is still scary. I think the guys right at the top are sort of out of my league right now, but... Guy directly in front, we might have a chance of him.
Whoa, he goes wide into the wall.
Yeah, touched the wall then.
Yeah,
saw the blue truck do that as well.
All right, side by side here. Stay low. You can get him here. And clear.
Ah, oh, understeering. Easy, easy. Okay. I think I'm going to lose position here, but I don't mind. I didn't want
to. Go for the black.
Oh no, he's
thinking better. He's going to help you out here.
Thinking better of it, apparently. I'm seeing bits of what I assume is rubber fly up in front of my my windscreen, so maybe we are burning the tires a little bit.
Well, yeah. This track plus the temperature, it's going to be shredding. I think this guy's trying to work with you, so just focus forward here. Hit your marks.
Trying to be a bit easier through there. Oh, damn it. I keep just running onto that apron a little bit, and it unsettles the truck on the exit. Really don't want to be doing that too much. We're on lap 22 now, so 13 to go. That line isn't too bad actually, as long as you get the truck facing downwards. Oh, I've got that wall guy in the guy behind me hit the wall.
Oh, yep, okay, that's good. No more pressure than behind. They're going too wide behind you, so focus on that blue car. Got cars a couple ahead of you there having some issues as well. Seems to be pretty spread out though. This probably go green the rest of the way.
Yeah, we can hope so. I mean, the only sort of hope we have is if someone in front just hits a wall or something.
That red truck's running the Larson line.
did you learn what that means now? Did you go
that's,
and Google
that's
that
all
afterwards?
I've heard about in the last 2 weeks. Oh, the Larson line. I'm like, what?
Yeah, I remember the stream when you were like looking for a guy called Larson in the race. Like, who's Larson? What lines are you running?
All right, up to sixth place here, looks like.
No, that was a lapped guy. So still in
seventh. This is still a pretty sweet overtake.
Still great. Oh man, that wall was scary.
Well, according to iRacing there, you gotta gain one more position. Number six car running seventh, though, after some... We didn't think you'd have pace, but you've proven to pick it up here.
Yeah, I think I'm just not good at on the fresh tyre, it seems. I think I'm a bit quicker on the tyres that are worn. It's just my practice was a bit bad. Oh, that's bad through there. The guy in front is pulling away a bit, unfortunately. I'm not sure there's much I can really do about it at this point. I almost felt like I was quicker coming out of four then, but I just can't. No, I think this is where I'm going to be. The guy behind is slightly gaining, so that's one to sort of keep an eye on.
Yeah, there's a battle ahead of you here, and we'll see how that plays out.
Oh, it's getting sideways. Gotta wheel it.
Oh, there's a wreck. There's a wreck. Stay high, 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 high. Oh, low, 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 low.
Okay. Well, that's right, interesting. Perfect. I'm not quite sure what we do now. I guess we have no choice but to take tires, because
you have to pit, yeah.
And see, this is where I'd be tempted to take two, but I had Matt tell me last week that just never take two tires. So.
Well, you know. No, you've gone quite a few green laps, so you just take full four here.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, but you got a chance at something special here.
Top five would be nice. I mean, like I said, we're trying to keep that top five dream alive, and again, sort of saying that I don't really have the pace. I don't think we actually have the pace to be where we are now, but hopefully we can do something. Also, our fuel will be fine. We've been on the caution a couple of times.
We got a smoker to your right.
What's he doing?
Vape Nation, bro.
He just... Where's he going?
Who knows? Retaliation! Here we go! Oh, the guy's getting out of the way. Retaliation! Nim Cross, call Nim.
Call Nim Cross.
Oh, look out! Go right. Oh.
Oh, sort it out, boy. Deuce. Get away from me. Sort it out on your own.
Getting a little chippy here in Texas.
Go faster, dude.
He's to your left. Careful, careful. Go left. Oh my gosh. Okay, go right. Amazing. He can't even hit that guy.
Oh my god. Okay, well, this might be good for us. This might actually give us a place. As shitty as this is for that guy, you might get a place out of it. But that's really bad form by that guy. And bear in mind, this is going to be on a video that people are going to see. So GG that guy.
Yeah, now remember, children, you're not supposed to do that. You're supposed to be respectful.
I'm not sure where we're going to come out there. I think we had a good stop anyway. So we might be up to fifth now. We might be up to fifth.
Yeah, we'll have to see when it updates. But that was good stuff.
That was really interesting. So what we'll do, guys, we did what we did last time. We'll come back when we know what's going on. So we actually, and then we'll I guess go to the end, hopefully. So we're back after pit stops. We are in fifth position now after that. Interestingly enough, the blue truck, the one we punted at the start of the race, hasn't actually pitted for tyres. So that's going to be interesting to see how that plays out for him. We're only going to have four laps to go to the green. Hopefully it will go green all the way so we get a chance to fight. If it doesn't, there's a strong chance we'll be finishing in the top five. So I'm going to keep one eye on the blue truck, and hopefully we can have a good run to the finish here. I mean, this time this happened at Auto Club. We got killed at Auto Club, so I'm really hoping it doesn't happen here. And hopefully you get no sort of retaliatory trucks come out of nowhere and just murder us.
Yeah, this is the home stretch, so burn them up, Jimmy. Here we go.
But keeping an eye on the guy in blue.
Yeah, try to stick to the low. The blue guy may want to stick to the low, so you may have to pass him high. We'll see how it plays out here.
What's this 14 doing? Just... what? Okay, trucks.
You got a guy to your right. Hold that low line.
Oh, what's this guy doing?
Stay to the inside. Oh, they're battling. You're clear. Go high. Go low.
Oh, uh-oh. Jesus Christ.
Go low.
Go
through. Go,
go,
go, go, go,
go,
go, go, go.
Do it.
Yes.
Do it. Where are we? Where are we? Where are we? Where are we?
In first place.
I don't know yet. Yes! We fucking yes! won!
Yes!
Yes!
Record points, oh champion! God. Here in Texas.
Holy
unbelievable.
Shit.
Oh, the wreck avoidance. Oh, Craigasm. Can I get some Craigasm in the chat, please?
Oh, my God. Our first win in the trials.
Oh, that's exciting, man.
Oh, my heart is going mental right now, dude. That was so cool.
Ooh, I don't know how you avoided that. They were going low, then they went high, and you just slipped right through them. It was so close, that guy. Almost tapped you right in the bumper.
I saw the gap. Wow. And just gunned it, man, and that was it. So,
woo!
Holy shit. We qualified in 14th. We had no pace, and somehow...
That's what trucking's all about, man.
Somehow we lucked into the win. Four car, please, no, don't kill.
Oh, no, look out.
What's he doing?
He's vape nation it.
Is he trying, is he trying to win?
You didn't have too many high hopes here for this race, but, wow.
Oh, wait, it's saying let the two car by. No!
No!
But we were passed. No, we didn't win. Fuck my life. We
can't. Oh,
my
man. Dreams have been shattered.
Bullshit, dude. I hope he
Third, though?
Third, yeah. I hope he blows up. Blow up. Oh, man.
Yeah, I'll have to stop.
I don't know. Yeah, the caution came out. Oh, damn it.
That's some BS. I'm going to have a talk to the steward there about this race.
Talk to him.
I'm going to write a strong letter.
Oh, man.
I think they got it screwed up.
So close. Heartbreak again. Always a bridesmaid.
Yes.
But that
hell
was
of a race.
Oh,
though,
his engine's gone.
Oh, he did die.
Second boy.
He's not gonna make it. What else is gonna now just take the guy.
Yeah,
out
just gotta fucking punt this guy and we'll be fine. This is the guy that was pole, by the way, so oh my god. This race we're not even racing. it's still happening. It's still happening.
Classic C fixed, I tell you.
Oh, Jesus. Well, guys, we have another lap of pacing to go yet, but we're going to be coming second here. And I'll take this opportunity to say a massive, massive thank you to Matt Malone for coming along and spotting. Hopefully it wasn't too boring for you, Matt, there at the end. It was.
No, it was a blast, man. This is great.
Pretty interesting. Apparently this guy's going to pit in, according to the race chat. But yeah, okay.
It was
I best put in,
yeah.
Man.
Oh, yeah, you got to fake it.
And, yeah, we nearly won. We came second there, but given how we came to come second, I don't really... I'm not too upset with that, to be honest.
Yeah, really. Yeah, it was great job all around by your wreck avoidance there. It was amazing. Like, usually you get caught up in some of that stuff, but if you're able to keep it clean, you can have a chance to win.
Yeah, we were just really lucky there not to get caught up, and... yeah, if you guys haven't already, then go check out Matt Malone over on Twitch, twitch.tv/showdown1983. He's always streaming some iRacing, always crashing, always wrecking out.
No. Hey, whoa. I usually hit Alt F4 before I fully wreck.
That is God tier iRacing, that is. Hit the Alt F4 before you actually crash. But yeah, he's, I think, probably the biggest iRacing streamer over on Twitch. Fantastic guy. And also, co-founder of Good TV with me.
Is that a fat joke?
The fattest guy on Grip TV. He's a co-founder of Grip TV alongside myself, and where I sort of disappeared, he turned it into something very special. So definitely go give him a follow over there. And also, he uploads his videos to YouTube as well. So if you're not quite the stream sort of person, you like prefer to watch YouTube videos, then you can go check out his YouTube channel as well. As the guy in front is mating with the safety car a little bit.
Yeah, I also stream on Hitbox Monday through Thursday.
To an audience of 5 people.
yes. I appreciate that, and thanks for letting me hang with you here and be your spotter for these. It's a cool series you got going, and I'd love to see it progress here.
Oh, man, I'm so sad we didn't win, though.
Yeah, who's on your radar for your next spotter?
Well, I've asked Sean Cole. I don't know if he's going to get back to me or not. We're probably going to have Ryan Littlemore on, who is a F1 YouTuber. I want to try and get KR on as well.
Oh, yeah.
Because I think KR will be really cool to have. And then after that, I'm not really sure. I guess I'll just try and look around and see who's interested, because we've got a lot of races to run. So the more people who are interested, the better. But yeah, I'm just going to just send messages and hope someone turns up, basically. That's my strategy.
There you go. Well, yeah, it should be fun. I've been enjoying watching them.
But here we are then, so coming around T4, T3, whatever, coming around the last oval bit
And they're coming around. Jimmy Broadbent and that number six guy going to be picking up second place.
So, I mean, we pretty much had the checklist, really. We punted someone. We had wreck avoidance. There was retaliation wrecks. I mean, we had pretty much the full C-fix experience. There it is.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Nice. But, guys, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that like button. If you really enjoyed it, hit subscribe to be notified of future videos. As always, guys, take care. Have an awesome day. See you next time. And goodbye to Mr. Malone.
Bye-bye.